You have run social media or Google Ads, and you've seen a good flow of leads coming in, but you don't know why many of them haven't booked in for consultation or come in into the practice to see you. In this podcast, we're going to talk about how to improve touch points to convert more leads into becoming new patients.
Welcome to the Online Marketing for Doctors podcast, the place to grow and scale profitable practices with your show hosts, Huyen Truong and Steve Tate.
Hello and welcome to another episode of Online Marketing for Doctors podcast. If you're new to this podcast channel, this channel is all about providing strategies and tactics that you can use to grow your practice fast. Make sure to subscribe to the podcast by hitting that little bell button, so you never miss out on a future episode. I'm one of your hosts, Stephen Tate, and my co-host from the intro is Huyen Truong.
Hello, everyone. When you get a lead, your goal is to convert them into a patient. This is actually harder than it sounds because with interactive marketing channels such as Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube ads, we're actually interrupting their social media use. So a lot of them won't follow up and don't come in after they sign up for that entry level or foot in the door offers, as the ads and signing up could be quickly escaping their attention span.
In our guest podcast interview number 33, we had a very interesting discussion with Dr. Nawabi from Vascular Health Center about direct response marketing and how to convert more social media leads into actual patients. He initially didn't have much success with his new patient conversion rate, which was at a low 5%, but he managed to move it all the way up to 25% by using a patient touchpoint strategy and follow-up system. And we're going to show you how you can do it too.
So in order to convert prospects into new patients, these are our recommended touch points that you need to generate to make sure that you are best maximizing your chances for converting leads into new patient conversions. Okay, so you have someone signed up for an offer on your website. Maybe it's to book in for a free consultation. The first touch point is the confirmation email and SMS, which can be automatically generated after a prospect signs up for the offers. If your sign-up offer requires a manual intervention to generate a booking, please handle this within the first 10 minutes after the lead sign-up. A dedicated staff member or call center staff should call the prospect immediately to book them in. Leads start getting called very quickly.
After the third and seventh day, if they haven't arranged their booking yet, they should receive two follow-ups or a call or voice drop message. Again, this can be automated as well. These will be used to help remind the prospect of their previous desire to claim this special offer. Following that, you'll still need another two touch points if they haven't booked in yet to your special offer. And these can be via text and email to remind prospects of the final call before your special offer's expiry date.
In general, you usually need to generate at least around four touch points: a call, a voice drop, email, or text for inspiring prospects to take action and make that booking. And as you can see in our proposed follow-up system, it can take up to 8 touch points to close a lead. But before we continue, let's take a quick break for a word from our sponsor.
Are you looking to increase your authority, reach, and engagement to convert more prospects and referrals without spending more of your valuable time? What you need is a marketing system that can run on autopilot and generate revenue 24/7 for your practice. What simple marketing system is this, you might ask? Through our years of promoting practices and running our own successful digital marketing agency, we have discovered the marketing system that you need to make this happen. We've documented all of our knowledge about this wonderful marketing system, our best strategies, tactics, processes, and templates in our soon-to-be-released, highly compact online course called How to Use Webinars to Increase Your Patients and Referrals. Automate your marketing to leverage your time and scale your practice. In this course, we provide you with all of the information and templates you need in an easy-to-follow, step-by-step process so that you can create your own effective webinar marketing system within just a few hours. Once done, this incredible, powerful set-it-and-forget-it marketing system will run in the background and generate new patient inquiries for your practice automatically. If this interests you, we'd like to invite you to go to this link, onlinemarketingfordoctors.com/webinar-marketing-system. Register your interest in this course so that we can send you a notification when the course is launched and ready for you to take advantage of. We hope to see you there.
Ah, I knew you were going to do that. All right, can we just get back to the podcast, okay?
For those prospects who still haven't booked in for your special offer, we need to retarget them and keep contacting them via different methods, as mentioned previously. Sometimes as much as up to 10 touch points before we can close that lead. And once they finally take up and claim that special offer, we need to send them a thank you message for the visit and send them all relevant information that may have come out of the special offer, like a treatment plan or reminder for the next appointment.
Please keep in mind to always try to book in the next appointment with any prospect after the first consultation or visit while they're still in the current appointment. That is one of the effective tips that we featured in our podcast number 23, 7 tips to make sure your leads become actual patients. The link to that podcast is in our show notes below for you to check that out after. So, in summary, you need to generate 4 touch points every week, using multi-touch points up to 10 points to convert a lead to a patient. We may wish it was just one thing in isolation, but in reality, it is a lot of different ways, continuously in combination, that are needed in order to convert a lead into a new patient. Follow-up, and more follow-up. Keep retargeting your message to them to stay front of mind is the key in obtaining future conversions.
Some of you may be feeling overwhelmed and wondering, how can we do all these tasks effectively? Thankfully, there's a software out there that can help automate your follow-up emails, SMS, and even voice dropped. Check out the software called Go High Level. It's a powerful tool that can handle all of these touch points for you automatically. Just set it once and forget it. It's our favorite type of system. We offer a special rate for this software package. So if you are thinking about signing up for this software, please let it know. If you're using Keep or ActiveCampaign, you can send automated follow-up emails and texts with these add-on extension or credit. We leave the links to this affordable and functional software in a show note below, so you can check them out for yourself and see how they can benefit for your practice.
But that isn't the only option. I mean, what about a call center? You know, hiring a local call center company can be an effective means of having ongoing communication with leads. You provide the call center with the script and campaign brief with instructions, and they can handle the follow-up with those leads who signed up for the offers and haven't booked in yet. Or even those who have booked in but need reminders to make sure that they actually show up for their appointments. If you run your promotion on a large scale, your internal staff probably won't have time or their full attention to take care of this tedious task, so automating or having a call center are great resources for getting the same functionality without the cost of additional staff.
Well, we have come to the end of today's podcast. Unfortunately, we have to say goodbye for now, but I'm curious and would like to hear from you too. What is your key takeaway from today's episode that you'd like to take some time over the next few days to start implementing? Or have you tried a different approach to convert more leads to actual patients? Has this worked well for you? Our healthcare professional or community would love and appreciate your input. Add your comments below or send us an email with your thoughts.
Be sure to keep in touch with us so we can continue to bring the best marketing strategies and tactics to grow and scale your practice. And don't forget to subscribe to our podcast channel so you never miss another one. We've got more great content planned for future shows, so you won't want to miss them. We look forward to seeing you next time. Bye for now.
Thank you for listening to the Online Marketing for Doctors podcast with Huyen Truong and Steve Tate. Be sure to check out the archive section on our website for previous episodes at onlinemarketingfordoctors.com/podcast. And subscribe to the show so we can catch you at the next episode.